The Dynamic Island is definitely one of my favorite features on the iPhone. But not only is it fun, it is extremely useful and extremely productive. But there's a lot of people that don't really know how to use it, don't know how to turn it on, or don't even know what the whole point of it is. That's why by the end of this video, you'll learn the most powerful tips, tricks, apps, and the most useful ways to use the Dynamic Island on your iPhone in 2025. So the first thing that we want to do is turn on the Dynamic Island. And fun fact, there's a lot of people that don't have it turned on. And I actually had a family member that didn't have it turned on. So this might seem really obvious to a lot of people, but you go inside of settings, then tap apps, and then find the app that you want to turn the Dynamic Island on. So as you can see right here, you're going to want to turn on live activities. And if this is turned off, you will not be getting a live activity or the Dynamic Island support within the app. So make sure to go through your apps of choice that you do want to use the Dynamic Island on. For example, YouTube is another good one, has a live activity that's pretty good. So just make sure to turn it on. Now that we know how to turn on the Dynamic Island, I wanted to show you a couple of tricks on what to do with it. And then I'm going to show you all the apps that are supported from Apple. And then at the end, I'm going to show you the most powerful apps that you need to download to truly unlock the full potential of the Dynamic Island. Let's tap on music and let's start playing Bad Bunny's latest album, for example. Let's go ahead and turn it down. And if we swipe up on the top, we're going to see the Dynamic Island. And there will be a tiny island animation for music showing you the waveform of the song with the album, which is absolutely stunning. And then if we hold on it, we're going to interact with the Dynamic Island. Now, depending on the app, it will give us different options. For music, it will let us skip a song, AirPlay a song. So if we want to send it over to our HomePods, we can skim through the song if we want it to the middle, or we can even favorite the song if we want. That's pretty much a basic of what the Dynamic Island does. Now, here's a powerful tip that not a lot of people know. Did you know that you can hide the Dynamic Island? It can be annoying sometimes when you don't want it there. So just by doing like that, you can hide it and unhide it just like that. Now, here's another tip that you might not know. So let's go ahead and tap on timer and let's start a timer. So if we go to the home screen now, we're gonna get another little Dynamic Island, which is now the timer. So you can have two full-on apps on the Dynamic Island. And you, if you swipe to the right, you can switch from one app to the other, or if you wanna swipe again, it will hide all of it. So you can switch from timer to timer and music. It is extremely customizable. If you only want timer, you can do it like that. Once again, you can hold, the timer will allow us to stop or will allow us to quit the timer. There's a bunch more apps from Apple that lets you use the Dynamic Island. There's also a pretty good one. If you start recording your screen, you'll be able to see if you're recording your screen or not. And then if you want to stop your recording, you can simply hold on it and stop the recording. Apple Maps also takes incredible potential of the Dynamic Island. If you swipe up, as you can see, it will give you some little directions on where you need to go. And it's really useful because you can be inside of an app, for example, let's tap on Kernel, and it will still be showing up. So it's great at multitasking when you're out in the street. If you're working, it will always pop up. If somebody's calling you, like someone's calling me right now, the phone app will also have tons of potential for it. It's pretty nice because you can either accept or end the call, and or you can just leave it there and hide it, or you can go ahead and answer the phone call directly from the Dynamic Island. Once you answer it, the waveform, as you can see, I am talking, and the waveform of me talking will actually simulate it right here, which is amazing. It will give you the duration of the phone call. If you hold on it, you can go ahead and put speaker, or you can simply and the call. Connectivity is also beautiful. So if I put my AirPods in my ear, as you can see, the Dynamic Island will show up. And if I hold on the animation, I'll be able to see my battery life plus this stunning animation letting me know that my AirPods are connected. The Dynamic Island can also expand when you're doing a payment on the App Store or using Apple Pay. Check it out. So if I double click to install, boom, it just used Face ID and it will expand, which is awesome. If I am Shazamming a song, the Dynamic Island will also turn on. The waveforms will turn on and will start detecting a song. I've got Billie Eilish's Bird of a Feather right now playing on my Mac. And boom, it will have this beautiful animation and it will let me know what song that is. I can tap on it, Shazam will open, and I can automatically open it in Apple Music and save it to my library. If I have my personal hotspot on and someone connects to the personal hotspot, So you can see, it will show up right here, which is a great way to know if someone is connected to your hotspot. If you start recording a voice memo and swipe up, Dynamic Island will show up. If you hold on it, you can just go ahead and stop recording. The waveform will also show up. In iOS 18, we have the flashlight, which is incredible, which also has Dynamic Island support. And this thing is absolutely stunning because it will let us turn up and turn down, control the brightness, the width of the light itself. This is truly one of the best ways to use the Dynamic Island in terms of the Apple ecosystem. It's just such a beautiful animation. And if you tap this right here, you can just turn off the flashlight. Obviously, the video is only about to get better, so if you're finding value out of this video, there's so many powerful apps for the Dynamic Island that I'm gonna be mentioning in this video. So if you're new to the channel, obviously hit that subscribe button for everything Apple and the ecosystem it surrounds. Trust me, you won't miss out. If you're a sports fan, there's so many ways that you can track your favorite football team, basketball team, baseball team, even Formula One has Dynamic Island tracking. This app right here is called FotMob, and it lets you track, in this case, your favorite football team. So all the teams that you decide to follow, it will show up in the Dynamic Island. Right now at 9 p.m., this game is about to start in 17 minutes, and there you go, as you see. And once the game starts, it will show me the current score, how the game is doing. And if you're a sports fan, you know how hard it is to keep track of so many different teams. So I've pretty much got my Dynamic Island turned on during the night because there's so many games that I like to follow. So just being able to keep track of all of those sports games just makes my Dynamic Island incredibly useful. But this is just for me, but I've got so many more useful apps coming up in the video. Now, tips and videos is incredible, but there's something way much more important than tips and tricks on your iPhone, and that is your digital safety. And that's why today I wanted to tell you about today's sponsor, which is ExpressVPN. Now, I personally travel so much, and if you want me to be honest, I connect to a lot of Wi-Fis that I probably shouldn't, but that's why I always try to have a VPN installed in my device. You see, what's crazy is that service providers can lock everything you do online, and in some countries, they even sell your data to advertisers, which is crazy. And that's where ExpressVPN comes in. It solves this issue by encrypting and rerouting 100% of your network traffic through secure servers. So next time you connect to a public Wi-Fi from a coffee shop or an airport, with ExpressVPN, it will protect you by wrapping your internet traffic in an encrypted tunnel, making it virtually impossible for hackers to access your data. Now, another reason on why you might need ExpressVPN is many websites or streaming services like Disney Plus or Netflix will offer different series or movie library depending on the country you're in. It actually happened to me this year that I love watching the Spanish show, and then when I go to the States, it's not gone and I can't watch it anymore. And I'm like, why can't I keep binging my show? Well, with ExpressVPN, you can change the online location to up to 105 countries. If you're still not convinced on why you might want one, think of the fastest speeds. Because ExpressVPN only invests in premium servers, making it extremely reliable. You can connect up to 8 devices as well. There's also this feature called Identity Defender, which is a new suite of tools to get your data removed from data brokers, and it will literally alert you when your data appears in the dark web. So if you want to find out how you can get 4 months for free of ExpressVPN, hit the link in the description or go to expressvpn.com/Nikias, or you can even scan the QR code shown on the screen. ExpressVPN, thank you so much for sponsoring this video. Now, my essential app for traveling is Flighty. Now, this app gives you so much information with your flight, all of your flight info, your boarding gate, and the Dynamic Island support inside of Flighty is so useful in so many different ways. First off, it will tell you your boarding gate. Obviously, right now, I'm not, you know, boarding a plane, so it's hard for me to show you, but here's a pretty good example on how it treats it. It tells you when your gate is departing, the time, the info, and during your flight, it will keep you updated for how much longer you have to be sitting in that airplane. Now, you won't believe this game right here. Now, this is Hit the Island, and it's literally a game that you're supposed to literally hit the Dynamic Island, which is extremely fun. Check it out. And once you hit the Dynamic Island, you'll get points. As you can see, I just got 1 point. I got 2 points for hitting the Dynamic Island. And once you keep on hitting it, and once the game continues, you'll have different achievements like these stars. The Dynamic Island can get wider, which is so much fun. It can give you different balls. Ugh. This game is just like, it doesn't make any sense, but it's so fun. Whoever made this game just loved the Dynamic Island so much that actually decided to make a whole game with it. I mean, come on, isn't this fun? Oh, I lost. All right, it's enough of those jokes and silly apps, and get started with the most powerful apps in this video. So this app right here is called Dynamic Notes, and you can basically add notes inside of the Dynamic Island. I just added this note called buy groceries. Let's just say you can't forget to buy groceries today, or you need to call someone, or you need to pick up a package from the mail. As you can see, there is now a 3. If I hold it, I will get that note, so you will never forget about it again. You can tap next and you can, you know, see all of the other to-dos that you have to do. You can copy it if you want. You can delete it once you've done it. You can tap on the X if you don't want it anymore. There's so many people out there that don't know that you can customize the Dynamic Island and personalize it with a special message, with emojis, with text, or obviously with photos. This is amazing. There's so much that you can do here. You can add quotes, social apps, productivity, friends and family. I just added this photo of me and my girlfriend in Ibiza that I absolutely love. You can tap launch. So you can see, it just personalized my Dynamic Island with these heart and star emoji, which is super aesthetic. If I hold on it, boom! I can look at my photo every time. There's so many ways that you can use this. You can add different photos, so every time you open your phone, you can look up to different photos and peek what's inside of the Dynamic Island. If it's bothering you for a second, don't forget that you can just hide it. If you want it again, you could show it up again. And as I said, you can add different shelves. Let's say you want a daily affirmation, which is have a fantastic day. You can tap save on it. And let's say, you know, you want to launch the have a fantastic day. Well, you can just simply, boom, daily affirmation, and it will run all day. So if you're having a bad day, daily affirmation, have a fantastic day. Isn't this app amazing? If you're new to the channel and you're finding so much value out of this video, you know what to do. Hit subscribe. Before I forget, the app is called ShelfBuy. Coming up next is an app called DynamicX. And DynamicX will basically let you monitor certain metrics inside of your phone. Let me explain. So you can tap on the plus and you can customize what you want the Dynamic Island to show you. You can see the speed upload in terms of your Wi-Fi, your download traffic for your network. If you want to track your memory, so your iPhone's memory, like your RAM, it will constantly be showing you your screen in terms of the frames per second. Like, this is extremely powerful. The processor, the date time, the date, the time. This example right here will show you all of your metrics with your internet speed. So if we tap on start activity and we swipe up, there you go. You'll now get your internet speeds, always updating it. Right on the Dynamic Island. And if we show, it will show you all the traffic. Like, there's so much customizability that you can add here inside of this app. I find the screen FPS right here, the frames per second, to be really useful, especially if you love gaming. I mean, this could be really useful for you. All right, let's get back to the fun Dynamic Island apps for just a second. PixelPals will allow you to choose a character from a penguin to a cat. And if you swipe up, you're gonna get a little kitty always being there with you. So if you're feeling sad for one day, you can just know that the kitty is always there inside of the Dynamic Island and vacation somewhere. I mean, just look at it. Can we all admire it for 5 seconds? Can we get like an epic zoom pan inside of it? Come on, it's amazing. Don't be so grumpy. If you hold on it, you can even feed it, play with it. Come on, tech can be fun sometimes, you know? So the app lock launcher is also one of the most powerful ones inside of this video. So you can basically add certain apps that you want easy access to. For example, I've added WhatsApp, Instagram, and music. And look what happens when I swipe up. You're gonna get this cool widget right here, which will give you the date and, you know, that it's Friday. Pretty amazing, but are you ready for this? You can hold on it and it will give you straight access to the music app. Now you might be saying, how on earth is this useful if I can just tap on this? But what happens if you're already inside of an app? You can quickly have access to certain apps like WhatsApp, boom, you're already in. You don't even need to open apps. You can also add different actions like a shortcut. So you can add a link from a shortcut. So let's say turn off the light so you can quickly access that. You can also add a bunch of custom links like a song or just apps in general. If you wanna open up, you know, Apple apps from different social apps to system toggles, shortcuts, VPN tools, like it can get crazy what you can do with it. My personal favorite way on using it is simply having certain apps open for easy access. And there's so much more that you can do with the Dynamic Island. Let me know if you want a part two. And if you want to discover how you can do this right here, hold on the action button and open up this beautiful secret menu. You can tap this video right here, or once again, you can hit subscribe and stay up to date with all these crazy Apple tricks that I just can't wait to show you more.